Hey, welcome to Gem Mint Collectibles. I am Gem Mint. If this is your first time at my channel, you are an honorary Geminite. All my other Geminites, it's time to mount up. A common question that I get is, what's the difference between an Omnibus and an Absolute Edition? So I thought I would not only do that, but just cover all the different types of formats that different publishers use. So we'll cover trade paperbacks, oversized hardcovers, library editions, deluxe editions, omnibus, absolutes, and more. So stay tuned and we'll get right to it. All right, we're back. So first things first, we're going to use a traditional comic book for scale. We're going to measure everything up to a comic book. Most people should have held a comic book if they're watching this video and have an idea of what the size is. The first type of format we're going to talk about is trade paperback, otherwise known as TPB. Trade paperbacks can be thin, 5 to 6 issues, or they could be thicker, and they could be called epic collections, complete collections. This one just happens to be the Complete Alien Saga Book 1. So I'll explain why Marvel or different publishers do this. This trade paperback collects 5 issues. And what they typically do when you have an ongoing series, like let's say Carnage for example, after the first 5 issues are released, they'll issue a trade paperback that collects those first 5 issues. This way they can double dip and sell the issues again, or some collectors just prefer to read them collected and not have to read it over a number of weeks or months. Or they could reprint older material and just do it in a soft cover format. Both of these are the same height as a traditional comic book. So that's your trade paperbacks. Then when we get into hardcovers, you have your standard size hardcovers. Now, each publisher will do their own thing. This is a Dark Horse book. This is a BPRD Plague of Frogs Volume 1. This is a DC book, The Master Race. Actually, I don't think Marvel really does standard size hardcovers, only in their box sets. But basically, a standard size hardcover is the same size as a regular comic book. It's just obviously hardcover and tends to collect more than one issue. Now, this, for example, Plague of Frogs, Dark Horse doesn't really do omnibus. They typically do oversized hardcovers, deluxe editions, library editions, and every rare occasion they'll do an omnibus type of book. But this is their standard size hardcover, and this is your DC. Now, why did DC make the Dark Knight Master Race a standard size hardcover and not an absolute? I don't know. You'd have to ask DC. But this is basically a way for them to charge $30 for a hardcover book. They probably have this in trade paperback format as well, but whatever. Next, we're getting into oversized formats. So the Image Deluxe Editions are hardcover books that typically do not have a dust jacket. And they are, as you can see, larger in height than a typical comic book. They actually are the same size as an omnibus or as a Marvel oversized hardcover. So whereas Image will call theirs deluxe editions, Marvel will call them oversized hardcovers or OHCs. So if you hear me say OHC, I'm talking about a Marvel oversized hardcover. Why is Avengers vs. X-Men an OHC and not an omnibus? I don't know. I don't know why they did it that way. They certainly have omnibus that are as thin as this. But we'll talk about Omnibus in a little while here. The Marvel OHCs typically do have a dust jacket. And then a hardcover book. Alright, now I want to talk about Omnibus. So I brought out a brand new Omnibus from DC Comics. This is the new Superman Exile and Other Stories Omnibus. This is one of my favorite books, actually, Uncanny X-Force by Rick Remender. And I just wanted to kind of show that the DC and Marvel Omnibus are really the same. They both always have dust jackets, hardcovers. They're usually thicker books. An Omnibus typically collects the entire run from a creative team or an entire story or event. So, for example, this Uncanny X-Force, it's both. It's the entire run, 1 through 35, plus the .1 issues, 5.1 and 19.1. But it's the entire Rick Remender run. The Superman, I'm not really familiar with the material, but like Infinite Crisis, for an example, has the entire main story of Infinite Crisis plus all the tie-ins. So that is the kind of difference between an omnibus and an absolute. An omnibus will collect everything related to the event, to the main story. It'll have every tie-in. Whereas an absolute, which we'll get to in a moment, only collects the main story. Back over here to Dark Horse. They have a couple of different versions of their library editions. The Hellboy library editions are wider than their deluxe editions. These deluxe editions are basically the same size as an absolute when I take an absolute out of the slipcase. The deluxe editions don't have dust jackets. They just typically have just a hardcover book. Their library editions can kind of vary. So all the Hellboy library editions have like a canvas kind of material on the outside. But then they have the Goon, which has a dust jacket and one of these on the inside. But the Dark Horse library editions are bigger than an omnibus. So that's kind of the difference between their premium kind of formats, if you will. The absolute format is something that, it's really a DC thing. Marvel does not have an absolute format like this with this size. They always have a hardcover slipcase, and they may or may not have a dust jacket on the inside. But if you remove all that, then this is basically the same size, height, and width of a Dark Horse Deluxe Edition. Again, the absolutes will collect the main story. So let me give you an example. The Infinite Crisis Omnibus, like I mentioned before, has the main story and all the tie-ins. There is an absolute edition for Infinite Crisis that just has the main story, however many issues it may be, only 12 issues, it could be 7 or 8. It can contain much less issues, but as you can see, the absolute editions are a larger format than the omnibus. The pages are taller, therefore the artwork is bigger. Not to be outdone, Marvel doesn't have an absolute edition, but they do have a vibranium. Sometimes it's called vibranium edition, adamantium edition, or platinum edition, which is basically a huge absolute style book. And you can see in comparison, this is much bigger than a regular comic book as is. Then Marvel comes out with these huge slipcase books. They don't typically come with a dust jacket, that thank God, but they just have these huge hardcover books that are the largest format that I've ever seen. And they typically are like a greatest hits of a character. Like the Wolverine has just his Frank Miller miniseries, Hulk 181, Logan, the Logan miniseries, some of his Weapon X Marvel Presents stuff. So they just kind of treat it like a greatest hits. Although the one platinum edition that they have is Alex Ross's Marvels, which is only 4 issues, but it's just oversized, an oversized format for his impressive realistic artwork. So I hope this video was helpful. I know the main question is usually, what's the difference between an absolute and an omnibus? The format is different, and what's collected is typically different. The thing with omnibus, it's not so much to collect issues 1 through 700 of Amazing Spider-Man. No, it collects the whole Stan Lee, Steve Ditko run. Then it's going to collect the whole John Romita run. Then you have Amazing Spider-Man by McFarlane. Spider-Man by McFarlane. Somebody commented recently, why does Spider-Man by McFarlane have 1 through 14, skips 15, and then goes to 16? And I explained to them that McFarlane didn't do issue 15, therefore it's not collected. It's not meant to be a chronological collection. It's meant to collect the entire run from a creative team, whether that be an artist, a writer, or both. And then an absolute really just collects an entire story or an entire event, like the absolute Dark Knight from the Frank Miller Dark Knight Return. So drop me a comment if you have any questions. I hope this was pretty clear. I included all the other formats just in case you were curious. Why are some bigger than others? Some are hardcover, some are softcover. What's an OHC? What's a TBP or a trade paperback? So if this was helpful, hit that like button. Drop me a comment if you have any questions. If you're new to the channel, stick around and make sure you subscribe because I do a lot of collection updates, collection videos, statue unboxing and reviews. I read these and do recent reads on them. And we do a weekly live show. And more recently, we cover Comic-Con. So make sure to check those videos out. Thanks for watching. Stay minty. Peace.